You're vegan? Where do you get your omega-3s?
Protein.
Calcium?
Protein.
Iodine?
Protein.
Magnesium?
Protein.
Iron?
Protein.
Zinc? Vitamin D?
Protein.
B12?
Protein.
Protein? Let's ask a doctor.
Protein.
It's Emily from BiteSize Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. I'm excited to bring to you the first video in a new series covering all the major nutrients of concern on a vegan diet with the incredible Dr. Michael Greger of nutritionfacts.org. If you're not familiar with Dr. Greger, he's a medical doctor, author, and internationally recognized speaker on nutrition, food safety, and public health issues. He's a licensed general practitioner specializing in clinical nutrition. He provides the invaluable public service of nutritionfacts.org, a totally free website and repository of videos and articles on the most current issues in the field of nutrition. And since he provides these free updates, as his site says, via bite-sized videos, I'm obviously a fan. So I wanted to be able to provide new vegans, the vegan curious, and even established vegans with a series of videos addressing the most common nutritional worries surrounding a vegan diet. And we're starting with the one every vegan hears more times than we can count, protein. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Greger, for giving us some of your very valuable time to sit here and tell us a little bit about how to ensure that you get proper nutrition when you're going on to a vegan diet.
Happy to help.
All right. So I thought we'd start with the one that's like the most controversial nutrient when you're talking about, you know, eating in a vegan diet, and that is protein. So I was wondering if you could talk a little bit about how it is that we get protein when we're not eating animal products.
Yeah, surprising there's so much fuss. So the average requirement is about 42 grams. Meat eaters get about 75 grams, and so do vegans, and so do vegetarians. Everybody gets about 70% more protein than they need. They only need about 0.8 grams per kilogram of healthy body weight. About 3% of people in the nation, in a study of about 13,000 people, a survey that the government does every few years, about 3% are not getting enough protein, but that's just because they're typically not eating a lot. If you don't eat enough food, you don't eat enough protein. So if you're on a severely calorie-restricted diet, you have to be more careful about nutrients. But, you know, but the ironic thing is, you know, there actually is a nutrient for which 97% aren't sufficient, but actually deficient, and that's fiber. I mean, the question isn't, where do you get your protein? The question should be, where do you get your fiber? Because fiber is the one that 97% don't even reach the recommended daily minimum. And that's the one that actually has consequences, been tied to, you know, getting sufficient amounts, lower rates of cancer and heart disease and diabetes and obesity and hypertension. And so, I mean, these are the nutrients we have to think about getting enough of living basically anywhere in the industrialized world.
And would you say that there's more of, at least with people who are getting sufficient calories, would you think there's more of a worry of almost getting too much protein rather than too little, like when we're eating animal products?
You just need to get, it's the source that matters, right? So when you're talking about carbs or fat or protein, it's really the source, right? Carbs are lentils and lollipops, right? Protein, you know, fat can be, you know, Crisco and lard, or it can be walnuts. I mean, you gotta, what's it, that's, you really just gotta care about the source. So you get whole food sources of nutrition. You don't have to worry about these things. So where do you get protein from? I mean, the protein superstars of the plant kingdom are the legumes, right? Beans, peas, you know, chickpeas, split peas, lentils. I mean, that's, we should all be including legumes in our daily diet. They're packed with all sorts of wonderful things. You can also get, you know, protein from whole grains and nuts and seeds and things. But I encourage people to eat legumes every day because they're so powerful in supporting a healthy long life.
I think that, you know, obviously, like, the protein one is what everyone focuses on. And just like you said, it's very much a non-issue, which is, it's kind of interesting when you really break it down and show people that there's really no concern. I've told people before, if you're eating enough calories, there's no way that you're not getting enough protein. So,
unless you're eating junk food. I mean, so there's
exactly.
No protein in cotton candy.
Mm-hmm.
Right? There's no, you know, so, I mean, you could eat a strictly vegan, sufficient calorie diet that's completely lacking protein if you just ate hard candy all day.
Right.
So it's important, you know, to be a healthy you know, plant-based eater, we have to actually eat our plants.
Absolutely, yes. Anything naturally made is going to have it in there.
I hope you enjoyed hearing from Dr. Greger on the issue of protein in a vegan diet. And one thing I really want you to remember in all of this, a vegan diet can be as varied as you want and can come in countless forms. So if the way that I eat or any individual eats doesn't work for you, don't swear off being vegan. You can eat any type of cuisine under the sun in a vegan version, even monolithic masterpieces like this. So I'd love to hear from you on this. Where do you get your protein? Seriously, where do you? If you're vegan, how do you answer that question? If you're not vegan, but thinking about maybe making your way there, is protein a concern for you? Let me know in the comments. If you found this video helpful, give it a big thumbs up and share it around to bust the protein myth. To help support BiteSize Vegan and keep the education coming, check out either of the support links in the video description below, or to get perks and rewards for helping out, join us in the Nugget Army on Patreon by clicking that logo right there or the link in the video description below. If you're new here, be sure to hit that big red subscribe button down there for more awesome vegan content every Monday, Wednesday, and some Fridays. I would love to have you as a member of the BiteSize family. And hey, while you're here, check out some of my related videos and stay tuned for the rest of the series with Dr. Greger. And all of the links to all of these and anything I've mentioned in this video are in the video description below for those of you who are on a phone or tablet and can't click them. Now go live vegan, get your protein, and I'll see you soon. Protein, 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 protein.